Yeah.
Problem in objectivism more so than elsewhere, because the heroes of Ayn Rand's books are perfect in Inception. We don't see Galt struggling. We certainly don't see Francisco struggling. I mean, there's an emphasis in the novel about how he never really struggles, except
that scene with the table and the, but yes.
Yeah. I mean, Dagny is a massive struggle, but generally he's just perfect. Everything he does is perfection. He doesn't seem to have to struggle and make those kind of efforts that most of us do.
Yeah.
I think it's more so an objectivism because
we're given this idea.
So embedded, so part of the philosophy in a sense.
Yeah. No, I definitely think that's part of it. And I've seen it more times than I can even, you know, count. And I think, and in myself and in pretty much everyone I know within this community, I think at some, almost everyone, very few and notable exceptions. Yeah. And I mean, I think that is a big part of it. And I think there are pre-existing vulnerabilities, I think, that we bring, that most people bring with them when they discover objectivism, such that it's like a perfect storm of having this lofty ideal held up to us, but in fictionalized, deliberately selective form, right? Where we don't, yeah, like, I mean, think about all the things we don't, like, we don't see them going to the bathroom, which thank goodness for that, right? But we also don't see them getting sick and feeling really dejected, and we don't see them falling into old habits that everybody has and sometimes, you know, has to fight against, and getting rejected by women along the way. And
it's art. I mean, and we live in a culture that doesn't understand art and doesn't know what to do with art.
So I think that's a big part of it.
You know, instead of viewing these as some kind of models or some kind of abstractions, they're taken literally. And yeah. I mean, I literally knew people who try to have sex like they do in Atlas Shrugged. Yeah.
Yeah.
Good. And it takes out all the humanity. It's a novel. It's not a recipe for how to live your life on a day-to-day basis.
Yeah. Although I want to channel Greg here and say, I agree with all of that. And I think the consequences are very real, but just to connect the dots back to what we were saying earlier about people sometimes having a model of the world where like only the negatives count or are real. I think we were talking about this actually before we started the call, but there's actually lots of really rich examples in the novels when it is plot relevant. Yep. Of character, you know, the fact that, and I didn't notice some of these until my third or fourth reading. The fact that Rourke throws away most of his designs because they're crap. Yep. He's throwing them in the waste bin. That was really surprising to me when I read it. And I thought he just always created amazing sketches just whenever he put his, you know, pencil to paper, you know, and the fact that.
Well, Reardon. I mean, Reardon is an amazing psychological character. I mean, the transition that he makes, the psychological changes that he makes, you know, based on the philosophical changes that he's making, are so insightful and so interesting. And many of us are much more like Reardon than we would be like John Galt. I mean, when I read the book, the last person in the book I could imagine being is Galt, right? Yeah. Because I was 16 and pretty dumb and, you know, and confused and all this stuff. And you just couldn't even imagine that. And I mean, I would think of myself more as a Eddie Willis, but if you're gonna be a giant, then Reardon is the guy you're gonna be, because you're gonna have to work it out. You're gonna have to figure it out. You're not just gonna have it.
Yeah, and it takes him a long time. Even having people like Dagny and Francisco around, it takes him decades.
How many speeches does he need to hear?
Right?
Many.
And you know, he has to go through a really ugly, horrible divorce, and he has to sell the rights to his best invention. And, you know, he doesn't exactly escape without costs.
No.
Yeah, absolutely. No. And even, you know, I think some people will read the novels and they'll think, I'm like Katie Halsey, or I'm like Cheryl, or, you know, or the wet nurse. And that can feel really intimidating and threatening for people, that, wait, they're the characters who didn't make it, you know, or even Winan. And but one thing I want to say about that is...
That's healthier than thinking you're Joe Galt, I think.
That's fair. Or thinking you're supposed to be.
Or you will be just because you read the book, or you will be because you're committed to the ideas now. I mean, you want to aspire, but
it's but you're supposed to already be. I mean, yes. Like I either have to already be like this person, or everything is lost and something's very wrong. Yeah.
And I can see that